The Nomads are the knitted nylon tonight. Jack Campbell, who was victorious the other night, is 12-2-1 on the season and a 2.36 goals against average. Connor Hellebuck, who was driven from the net the other night, is back in goal for Winnipeg. Controlled now by Winnipeg, played by Forbert out at center. And Dubois gets it in on the left wing. A pass in front. They score! Right off the hop, Ehlers cutting in off the right wing, deflects a pass high and over the shoulder of Campbell. And where the Leafs scored 27 seconds into the game the other night, this is 29 seconds into the match.
Well, what happens, you get both defensemen, Riley and Brody, on the right side of the rink. Well,
Nylander got knocked down, puck comes free. Tipped in at the blue line then by Muzzin. Now Nylander back to Muzzin. Muzzin with a wrist shot in traffic. Caught by Hellebuck. And Galchenyuk is in the middle of it with Pionk. And this might have something to do with the Lowry exchange the other night. Pass into the slot. Shot by Spezza just off the mark wide. Kept in at the blue line. Comes back to the point. Brooks with a shot that's deflected wide. The wraparound scores! Joe Thornton is definitely getting this one, and the Leafs have tied the game at ones.
And this time, the 27-game goalless streak is going to officially come to the end. It was Spets and Thornton that had the best chance for the Leafs early on. First, Spets misses on a long shot that went wide but seemed to handcuff Connor Hellebuck, and now a shot from the left point gets deflected wide, but Thornton, who is in front of the net, goes behind the net to pick it up and just swoops it around and stuffs it.
Back to the blue line. A shot goes well wide of the Leaf goal. Trapped by Pionk to keep it in on a point shot. Is into the glove of Campbell, and he's going to hold on. Now here's Kerfoot, rink wide. A shot on goal kicked away by Hellebuck off the stick of Morgan Riley. Head for Spezza. He'll just get it out. Stanley then gives the puck away. Pass on the left wing for Thornton. In for Brooks. He's got a man in front. Spezza goes to the backhand. And it went off his stick and went harmlessly wide. Nice three-way passing play there by Thornton and Brooks.
A tough, strange walk back to the press box when the Leafs get back to
score. Here's a bouncing puck in front of that. They score! Oh, my! Mitch Marner gets a benefit of a huge bounce off the boards with Hellebuck in behind the net, and the Leafs take a 2-1 lead. Finish your thought, please.
Well, we go right from talking to Peter Speedon, who we have always heard the official score tonight, Peter Speedon. And as we say that, the Leafs officially score on a strange one.
Here are the Jets playing it back in over the line with a minute to go in the period. Oh, a good hit there by Sandin. And down in a heap is Blake Wheeler.
And Wheeler has missed time with a concussion earlier this year.
And now Sandin and Kyle Connor getting into it a little bit.
We'll take a look at it again. Well, they get to the puck at the same time.
And it looks like Connor is going to get the only penalty.
And it looks like Blake Wheeler is okay. He chipped it past Dermott. Sandin got to the puck, but was actually facing the backboards. But does he leave his feet? Maybe a little bit to brace himself for the impact from Wheeler.
Matthews to Riley. Riley to Marner, closing with a pass and a slap shot. The puck is still free, and now into the glove of Hellebuck, as thundered to the ice by Mason Appleton was Matthews in front of the net.
Only 10.3 seconds left on the clock here. And if the Leafs can't win the draw and find the back of the net, they'll start the second period with a man advantage. I don't know about you. I'd prefer Austin Matthews on the right wing side.
Joe Thornton has become the oldest Toronto Maple Leaf ever to score a goal. 41 years, 296 days, bettering the mark of old snowshoes himself, Alan Stanley. Kyle Connor. Sandin trying to settle things down. On the wing it goes. The Leafs with a 2-on-1. In and goes to Tavares. He scores! What a strange turn of events. three odd man rushes, and the Leafs finally score.
And it's all done 4-on-4 where the Leafs make a bad decision. Instead of going to the net and the man going to the net for a redirection, they go to the high slot. It's picked off.
Free it up now for Winnipeg. The penalties are over. They're back to full and even strength and a lead pass. Here the Jets. Oh, a great save made by goaltender Jack Campbell. That looks for Marner. Off to the far side. Marner back to the blue line to Riley. Now to Matthews again. A shot. Same result. Rebound coming in front of the goal. A scramble in front of the net. Down is Hellebuck. And the puck comes free back to the blue line.
I have no idea how this stays out. Willie Nylander's in front of the net. It looks like he gets the perfect redirection. Hellebuck makes a great save, and then I believe the second chance goes off the blocker of Hellebuck.
Comes back to the blue line to Riley. Now to Matthews on the left side. A little toe drag, and the shot is stopped. There's a rebound in front of the net. Another shot by Matthews. They deflected it on goal, and it is covered up by Hellebuck.
Boy, what a save.
On the doorstep.
What a save by Hellebuck on the John Tavares attempt. So Hellebuck's been fortunate here on the penalty kill.
Now he looks to come to center and brings it in on the left wing. Now goes to the net, trying to drive the net. And it was knocked away at the short side by Hellebuck. Trapped at the blue line by Marner to keep it in. Not out. Kept in at the blue line by Pionk. A pass off a leg, though, comes to center. And out of the penalty box is Kerfoot with an angle down the left wing and a shot for the corner. And the quick hand of Hellebuck came up and snatched that out of the air.
Sure, if anything got to Jack Campbell. On that, they've got now three shots on goal for the Jets here in the second period. The Leafs have 11.
Here's Sandin working in with a shot, and that was off Hellebuck and wide of the goal. Kept in at the blue line by Riley. Going to play the puck around the boards, but it's cut off there by Dubois, and a shot high and wide of the goal. Where is it? It comes bouncing off the backboards and almost bounced into the net. Now the Jets into the slot, a shot. That's wide, and the Leafs finally get a hold of it and get it out at center. Now the Leafs have it back in on the right side. Galchenyuk into the slot for Kerfoot to the right wing side, a shot off the shoulder of Hellebuck and wide of the net. Kerfoot. So we are starting the third period. Leafs to the left and the Jets to the right, and the Leafs start with 1:05 on the power play.
We said in the commercial break, this is where the power play can help put games away.
Dean over to Marner. Marner down low. A centering pass in front. A jam play, and it didn't work, and it's cleared to the line. Good play by Sandin. Al Nylander in for Marner. Marner trying to saucer it in front, and Matthews was stopped there by Hellebuck. Puck around the boards near corner. Seconds left in the power play. Marner at the blue line with a shot. Pad save. Rebound. Oh, and a great save made by Hellebuck. And the puck comes up on the wing. Now here the Leafs in over the line with Marner. Trying to center Matthews. And it was off the glove of Hellebuck and went just wide to Morrissey. Far side for Wheeler. Now to Morrissey again. To Shifley, and a one-timer was fluttered well wide of the Leaf goal. Final seconds in the penalty with 10 left. It goes off to the right wing side. Back to Pionk again. And that was whistled wide of the goal.
By the way, that point shot by, was it DeMello?
Yeah.
Hit the goalpost.
Shifley holding into the corner. Still with it. Shifley working back with a pass. It was blocked. It's poked out at center ice. Mikheyev trying to work wide. Took a slash. Took another slash. And then hit the goalpost. Now it comes in front of the net. And Kerfoot is going to score.
There was a penalty, though, that was going to be called on that. But Mikheyev stuck with it. He hit the side of the net after taking a couple of slashes in the hands. Hit the side of the net, went to the left-wing corner, picked it up, and threw it out to Kerfoot, who just tapped it into the empty net.
Into the Toronto end, just 5 seconds left, and it will be flipped to the line and out as Stanley gave Foligno a bit of a shot at the end of the game. Not sure if anything more is developing there, but it doesn't appear to be because David Rittich, the backup goaltender, has come out of the walkway where the Leafs go to their dressing room at the arena in Winnipeg, and all of the rest of the Leafs are there to congratulate Jack Campbell, who comes up with his 13th victory of the season, and other than giving up the goal that he had no chance on 39 seconds into the match, he's perfect.
And that's huge. When you're trying to get your confidence back, I still thought, I mean, he made the big save off Dubois two nights ago in the third period with the Leafs holding on to a one-goal lead. Now you give up a goal on the first shot in the first minute of the next game. Your confidence really isn't at 100% yet. And he came back. He wasn't overworked in the second period, made a huge stop in the second and some big ones in the third to preserve the victory. And here's a neat little stat that last year when Freddie Anderson was not in goal, the Leafs were 7-12-2 with the goaltenders that played, which included Campbell and Michael Hutchinson. This year now they're 17-5-3. Big part of that is Jack Campbell, but that is the Leafs record with Freddie Anderson not between the pipes. So you always say it's huge. You can't be below 500 with your backup goaltenders. You can argue who the backup goaltender is right now, but Jack Campbell is looks like he's rebounded and looked a lot more like the guy that won 11 straight than the guy that struggled in three.
They have added an assist on the empty net goal by Kerfoot, so it is Mikheyev and Hall who draw the assists as the Leafs win this one by a 4-1 count. They outshoot Winnipeg 10-9 in the third for a 37-26 advantage in shots on goal.